Please be seated. Good evening. My name is Don Rose. I am the Chief Administrator here at Great Lakes Christian High School, and I want to welcome on behalf of the Board of Directors and the staff here all of you who are family, friends, volunteers, students, guests, and of course to each of you, our graduate candidates, to our graduation ceremony 2022. You may or may not have noticed when you came into the building today that our flag is at half-mast, and actually it has been for over a year, and many people, almost once a week at least, ask why. On May 28, 2021, just over a year ago, more than 200 unmarked graves were discovered at the site of the Kamloops Indian Residential School. And since then, 2,000 other unmarked graves have been found at a dozen similar sites across our country as recently as June 6, 2022. So to mark a commitment to reconciliation and systemic change with and toward Indigenous peoples in our country, the Canadian government lowered flags to half-mast more than a year ago. And it is continuing to work with Indigenous groups to clearly outline how this reconciliation and change will happen. Moreover, for us, we identify with this because we are a Christian school and we have students who live in dormitories and we have students in our school who are Indigenous. So until a clearly articulated way forward is made public, we have decided to keep our flag at half-mast to honor lives lost and indicate our strong desire to see reconciliation and change happen. As another expression of that commitment, we want to acknowledge that we are meeting on Aboriginal land that has been inhabited by Indigenous people from the beginning. As settlers, we're very grateful to be able to have the opportunity to meet here, and we thank all generations of people who have taken care of this land. But long before today, as we gather here, there have been Aboriginal peoples who have been the stewards of this place. So in particular, we want to acknowledge the traditional territory of the Anishinaabeg, Ojibwe, Chippewa, and Haudenosaunee peoples. This territory is covered by the Upper Canada Treaties. But there's another reason we want to make this acknowledgement. It is important to us because of the students in this particular graduating class. For these students, more so than many of the ones that have come before them, although it's been part of our school for years, they are interested in social justice, anti-racism, and the elimination of systemic discrimination. It is vitally important to these young people. And they have shared how in our own school, we need to be more inclusive and more accepting. And so thank you, graduates. Thank you for your passion. Thank you for your courageous voices that you've used this year to help all of us to live up to the call that God gives us to love one another because we are all made in God's image. And today is a special day because you're graduating high school. It's a rite of passage. It's a closing chapter in the book of your life. And we gather here today to honor and to celebrate you, who, through God's grace, many prayers, personal commitments, diligence, sweat, more than a few tears, you have earned the right today to be considered high school graduates. But today's special for another reason. All of us are here, gathered together in one place. And I want to acknowledge and welcome those of us who are joining online. But in June 2020, there was no graduation ceremony, but months later in October, something that we did online. In 2021, after nearly 4 months of being out of school, we did rejoice because we could have an outdoor, physically distanced graduation ceremony. But we rejoice even more tonight that you are able to graduate in person, together with your peers, together with your loved ones. And that is something we no longer and may never again take for granted. So we are so glad that you and so many of your loved ones could join us here tonight. We want to acknowledge, too, that for you, this generation of students, you've had challenges in the last 2 years that few have ever faced, and that makes celebrating tonight with you even more joyful. And our earnest prayer for you graduates, for the class of 2022, that as you journey forward, it is better than the journey that's brought us here tonight. June 2022, marks the completion of our 70th year of operation. And the class of 2022, you are the 69th graduating class from Great Lakes Christian College. And after this ceremony, 2,113 students will have graduated from our little school. Now, being a Christian school, we have a vision to educate you for kingdom service. We have hopes for you. We have prayers for you. We are really excited to see what you're going to go out and do in our world. But we pray that you leave here closer to God than when you arrived, that you're a little wiser, maybe a little more knowledgeable, certainly, I hope, more mature, and much more conscious of what it means to be a conscientious citizen, not just of the world, but of God's kingdom. So as you leave, we hope you feel that people here care for you and love you, and that you feel equipped to continue to seek, serve, and become like Christ. So it's in this spirit that we ask everyone please to stand for a prayer and to remain standing after that for the singing of our national anthem.
Let's bow our heads and pray. In Jesus' name, thank you, Lord Father, for this day, for this wonderful day. The day we all greet us, thank you for helping us along the way. I just pray that whatever we do next year, we take you along with us. I pray for the graduates that they shall acknowledge you in all your ways and trust you even when things are not going their way. Let your will be done today and forever. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Let's sing O Canada together.
O Canada, our home and native land, true patriot love in all of us command. With glowing hearts we see thee rise, the true north strong and free. From far and wide, O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. God keep our land glorious and free. O Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Stand on guard for thee.
You can be seated.
Good evening. My name is Noel Walker, and I am the chairman of the board of directors. I'm also a member of the class of 89 and a parent of four graduates. Mr. Rose and Mrs. Kennedy, faculty and staff, parents, and friends of our school. On behalf of the Great Lakes Christian College Board of Directors, I want to extend my congratulations to you, the graduating class of 2022. In spite of pandemic restrictions and almost certain uncertainty, you have completed your high school education with distinction. We on the board are proud to count you amongst the more than 2,000 graduates of our school over the past 70 years. We are also very proud of the exemplary work that you have done and the work of your teachers and staff over these past couple of very difficult years. There has never been a more difficult time to run a residential Christian school, but at the same time, there has never been a greater need for young people, a greater need to prepare young people for a post-secondary education with a firm academic foundation, as well as a compassionate and grace-filled spiritual foundation as well. This year, there have been some loud voices here in Canada and in Western culture who have said that freedom is all about choosing your own ends. But the Bible tells us that this is a shallow imitation of true freedom. It is a philosophy of the age, a philosophy for the privileged and for the few. The example of Jesus demonstrates that we will not find true fulfillment in freedom from mandates or freedom from restrictions, but rather in finding freedom to, freedom to love, freedom to serve, and freedom to sacrifice. Sacrificing for the benefit of others. In a few moments, Janica is going to share with us the scripture theme that has been chosen by the student council for the 2022 and 23 school year. And while I don't want to give away the choice, such an appropriate text for such a time as this, I want to pray on your behalf that God, the God who made us, the God who prepared us for times such as these, will indeed overcome the spirit of falsehood that has captivated our world. May God bless the graduating class of 2022 with wisdom and with courage for the challenges that lay ahead. May God give all of us a spirit of kindness and grace for each other. May we see past our differences and begin to restore only the best of what we have lost. Lord, give us the imagination to dream of what could be better through Jesus Christ, the Son of the living God. Amen.
I'm going to be reading from Proverbs 3, verse 5 to 8, and it says, "Trust in the Lord with all your heart, and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways submit to him, and he will make your path straight. Do not be wise in your own eyes. Fear the Lord and shun the evil. This will bring health to your body and nourishment to your bones." Amen.
I'll be reading from John 16, verse 32 to 33. "A time is coming, and in fact has come, while you will be scattered each to your own home. You will leave me all alone, yet I am not alone, for my Father is with me. I have told you these things so that in me you may have find peace, and in this world you will have trouble. But take heart, I have overcome the world."
Thank you, ladies. Gianna read our verses for this current school year, and Janica read our ones for next year. I have the pleasure of introducing Wanu. She is your valedictorian. And and I know that she is excited and nervous as well to speak to you today. Wanu is continuing her education at McMaster University, and as a grad, we've already talked about some great places to hang out and study. Wanu is going into integrated business and humanities. But Wanu academically is just a very small part of why we love Wanu. Wanu has done great in her classes, but more than that, she is kind, she's funny, she's giving, she's a good friend, and you can always count on her. So we look forward to hearing from Wanu.
Okay, so before I lose your attention as quickly as Mr. Ellis did with his grade 12 advanced functions class, I would like to use these precious first couple of minutes that we're all awake to say a few thank yous. We're so glad everyone is here today online and in person. Some of our parents, like my mom, weren't able to travel here today, so I want us to recognize that they're still with us in spirit. In fact, when I called my mom this morning to show her my outfit, her opinions were quite strong, and it felt like she was right there beside me. Our class wants to make sure that we thank our supporters, the parents, teachers, dorm supervisors, life coaches, maintenance staff, board of directors, even Mr. May, our resident Bob the Builder, who just so happened to do a little bit of everything on campus. Actually, an extra special thank you to Mr. May for always coming in clutch with the Zamboni and making sure that we never had any snow days. For our parents who live thousands of miles away, thank you for sacrificing resources and time with us, and also thank you for the late night phone calls and early morning supportive text messages and all the other ways you have and continue to support us. Others have parents who live close by and must deal with our drama and tantrums on a daily basis, so thank you. A special thank you to the Waves who provided our box lunch today and worked tirelessly to raise money for scholarships and things that we need around the school. parent council who arranged the lovely flowers and continue to raise funds for things that we need. Our alumni contributors, thank you because you are the reason why GL is what it is today. But last and most important, thank you, God, for your mercy and grace that follows us everywhere. And to everyone not mentioned, thank you, thank you, and thank you again. We would not be here without you. You see, after I wrote all that part, I looked at the corner of my screen and saw that it was 5:50 a.m., a little over 12 hours left before this very moment. And that was all that I had written. And I had like 5 minutes to fill, so I was kind of nervous. That's when I remembered what Mrs. Kennedy told me when I was in her office yesterday. She said, if you don't know what to say, just roast people and do it with a smile so they think that you're joking. So if I say something out of pocket today, don't take it off of me. I graduated. Take it off of Miss Kennedy. So thank you for everyone for listening to my valedictorian address, and welcome to the Roast of Great Lakes by yours truly. Now, I would like to highlight some of my favorite moments from this school year. We finally had a chance to have a school play this year, which was very exciting. Thank you to the lovely cast of did anyone ever actually know how to pronounce that? We got a chance to meet Beamsville's fabulously flawless, faithful triplets, Erica, Ola, and Chisholm. And we saw Sophia Benton shine on stage, making every night a truly different experience. I mean, I heard the scripts is only a suggestion anyway, Sophia. This year was also very special because our lovely chorus started to travel to sing again. I think we can all relate that hearing Tito's song was a truly memorable moment. And of course, I can't help but mention that one time the Malachi got a little lightheaded on stage. Oh, we all know how that went. Thank you, Teddy, for coming to the rescue. I unfortunately wasn't there to see that moment, but I can clearly picture it in my head. Now, for some special recognition for the girls' volleyball team winning their zone championship. You guys seem to give Mr. Cook a tiny heart attack every single game. You do know that it's possible to win before 5 sets, right? Just saying. Congrats to those that went out for badminton and quite frankly smashed it. Making it to SASA is a truly noteworthy experience, so you all should be extremely proud of yourselves. And to the rest of the team, at least you had fun. That's all that matters. On another note, congrats to the boys' basketball team for winning the championship as well. We saw some pretty sick dunks this year, and we also got to see Toby play. However, I actually didn't enjoy this season. Every time I close my eyes, I still picture Angel and Ola yelling at me from across the court because I made a tiny mistake with the scoreboard on a season-defining game. We even got to stick it to Smithville Christian this year with our boys' soccer team winning zone and making it to SASA. That was probably our first time doing so since Mr. Azzo got his current car, which is probably older than me, just saying. Girls basketball this year was more of a semi-learning experience, that's how you said it? And we had a huge girls soccer team as well. I thought I heard there's power in numbers, but for some reason that didn't apply to us this season. But like I said, we had fun, and that is all. You guys had fun. I didn't play. You guys had fun, and that's all that matters. I know we probably mentioned this a lot, not as often as Mrs. Mon talks about her trip to Hong Kong, but still, this year was a year of setting records and breaking boundaries for real. I mean, look at what we did with the Community Service Day goal, from $20,000 to $25,000 to $30,000. And as a bonus, we all saw Mr. Banta accelerate at 9.8 meters square as the normal force was removed and there was real life demonstrations of buoyancy and gravity at work. I didn't take physics, but I feel bad for you guys for learning all of that. To anyone that even pressed share on the link, and to my lovely planning committee, Erica, Sadie, and Demi, and Mrs. Tallman, Thank you for allowing us to see that moment. To our incoming student council members, I'm sure you will do a great job if you have half of the amazing team that I got to work with this year. Sadie, Gianna only has like, what, size 6 shoes, so I guess those will be too hard to fill. And Sophia, I hope you show up a little bit earlier for meetings this year. Now, can I get a holla from my Perry Hollas? Perry Hall wasn't only a home for me, but it was a home for Ratatouille too. We've been through highs and lows. Highs like singing the entire Annie soundtrack. I mean, it really was a hard knock life for real. And lows like every other night before a calculus test. Thank you, Mr. Azzo. Right hand gang. Shout out to Mr. Azzo for naming an entire math procedure after me. And for the grade 11s taking calculus next year, always remember, take the derivative and set it equals to 0. Another special shout out to someone who begged me to mention her in my speech today, Sharon. I'm kidding, she only coerced me gently. I say this with the utmost sincerity. I will not be standing on this stage without walking through the past 7 years with you beside me. You have been an inspiration, support system, and one of the best friends that I could ever ask for. It's never too late to change your mind about Ryerson. Come to Matt. Anyways, now something inspirational for the future. There is nothing that I can say to match the advice and uncertainty that faces us all, class of 2022. So at times like these, there are no other words to rely on than those from God. Philippians 1, verse 9 to 11 says, "This is my prayer, that your love might become even more and more rich with knowledge and all kinds of insight. I pray this so that you will be able to decide what really matters, and so you will be sincere and blameless on the day of Christ. I pray that you will then be filled with fruit of righteousness, which comes from Jesus Christ, in order to give glory and praise God. Amen." Thanks, and good luck, class of 2022. And to those who will be standing on the stage, in the words of Mr. Ellis, I hope you fall in love with this school just as much as I did. Thank you.
Student participants, you can go join the class in a second.
The next video presentation is a special one. Wanu actually alluded to it. It was late in the school year when our chorus was able to sing together in the first time in 2 years, in one space, and to actually sing in front of a couple of live audiences. However, given the little time that they actually were able to share their gifts, Josh Hunter arranged for them to record 2 songs accompanied by videos. One of those 2 songs, "Whom Have I in Heaven," was written by one of our graduates, Tito, who took the words of Psalm 73 and created the musical arrangement we'd like to share tonight in its world premiere. May it serve as a word of wisdom and of blessing to all of us, but particularly to the class of 2022.
Who am I in heaven but you? And earth is nothing I desire but you. Who am I in heaven but you? And earth is nothing I desire but you. Who am I in heaven but you?
That was just beautiful. Welcome to all our parents, guardians, loved ones, and guests. And we welcome all of you here in person and all of you who are with us online. I cannot begin to count all the blessings of this year, but I do know that 33 of them are sitting in front of me today. It is my absolute pleasure to walk this very last day with them in what has been a really long journey. Some have traveled across the world to get here. Others have crossed a desert of emotional and mental challenges, and all of them have navigated a really difficult time throughout COVID. It is my pleasure to present the graduating class of 2022. Graduates, will you please stand? Dr. Walker, Chair of our board, faculty, family, and supporters, these young adults have fulfilled the requirements necessary to receive the Ontario Secondary School Diploma, as mandated by the Ministry of Education in the province of Ontario, and the Great Lakes Christian College Diploma that, in addition to academics, highlights service, Bible proficiency, and citizenship. I submit them to you to receive these respective diplomas with all of the rights, privileges, and responsibilities hereto entrusted. Graduates, Mr. Williams will help guide you to the stage. As they are getting organized and ready to be presented to you, their family and friends, I'd like to share with you a little bit more about our ceremony today. During COVID, we decided to blend together two really important ceremonies to us. The first was our baccalaureate service, which in the past has always taken place at the Beamsville Church of Christ. Our brothers and sisters there hosted us as we bestowed a personal comment and a blessing on each of our graduates. The challenge is that it took place always during our students' busiest week of exams and graduation. In addition, it was really difficult for our parents and family who came from Toronto to get to Beamsville for an evening event and then turn around and come back on Friday. The second event is this, our graduation ceremony. Tonight, we are continuing on with blending these two services to ensure that each student is recognized for their academic, athletic, and service accomplishments, but just as importantly, for their spiritual contributions to our school. At the end of first semester and the end of second semester, staff were encouraged to share observations, anecdotes, and encouragements for each graduate. Mr. Rose has worked long hours to knit those comments together and prayerfully choose a verse for each graduate to bless and honor them. Tonight, I will read out the accomplishments of each student, and then Mr. Rose and I will switch back and forth between reading the blessings. Each student will also receive the blessing in their graduation folder. Tonight, we may have a couple of students who come in late. As you know, some of our graduates are anxious to get home, and depending on their destination, needed to have different tests in Toronto today to ensure that they can leave on Sunday for their flights. So it's our plan to read for those students, even if they're not here, or if they are able to sneak into line. Thank you. Tonight we'll begin with Jerry. Jerry, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma. Jerry is a quick thinker, sure of who he is, and well-spoken. He uses his commanding voice to communicate his convictions and to support others and their accomplishments enthusiastically. Others appreciate Jerry's infectious smiles and envy his confident dance moves. For Jerry, Blessed is he whose help is in the God of Jacob, whose hope is in the Lord his God, the maker of heaven and earth, the Lord who remains faithful forever. Psalms 146, 5 to 6. Wanu, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Ontario Scholar Certificate, WAVES Honor Certificate, Citizenship Medallion, the Joey Merlin Community Service Day Award, second place, Excellence in Education Award for Business, Dean's Medal as Valedictorian, Female Honor Student, Female Citizen of the Year runner-up. Wow.
Wanu's eager. She doesn't want her blessing. Wanu is a driven and high achiever who asks insightful questions about academia, our world, and life in general. She is thoughtful about the things of God, helpful and engaged in all that she does, and always a friendly visitor. Wanu is funny. She has a positive, optimistic attitude and is mischievous in a good-natured way. To Wanu, may the God of peace equip you with everything good in doing his will, and may he work in you what is pleasing to him through Jesus Christ. Hebrews 13, 20 to 21.
Miriam, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma. Miriam's quiet and kind and soft-spoken nature makes her a calm and dependable presence. She is a supportive team player with whom it is easy to get along. Miriam uses her rich imagination to weave amazing stories. She has a sweet voice and an even sweeter personality. For Miriam, for the Lord God is a sun and shield. The Lord bestows favor and honor. No good thing does he withhold from those whose walk is blameless. Psalm 84, verse 11. Deborah, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Ontario Scholar Certificate, WAVES Honor Certificate.
Deborah leads with her generous smile, as she just evidenced. She reveals a light heart, and she enjoys other people and being with them. Respectful and quietly influential, it may be easy to miss her fierce and feisty spirit. Deborah's light is a tremendous encouragement, particularly when the world sometimes feels dark. So to Deborah, you, O Lord God, keep my lamp burning. My God turns my darkness into light. It is God who arms me with strength and makes my way perfect. Psalm 18, 28 and 32.
Brian, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma. Brian is quietly confident, doing what all of us should, but few of us do, thinking before he speaks. He has a great laugh and a gentle demeanor, and he is like lightning on the soccer field. Humble, Brian does not seek the limelight, but he always seems to be in the know. He is a steady and stable presence. For Brian, do not throw away your confidence. It will be richly rewarded. You need to persevere so that when you have done the will of God, you will receive what he has promised. Hebrews 10, 35 to 36. Sophia, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Citizenship Gold Bar Second Level, and our Drama Award.
Sophia is an authentic, passionate, creative, and infinitely expressive young woman. She cares about social justice, telling powerful stories, and looking at life and the world from unique and very perceptive perspectives. She's got a beautiful sense of humor, and her grin often says all there is to say. Sophia's not afraid to be her own person. So, to Sophia, be strong and courageous. Do not fear or be in dread of any, for it is the Lord your God who goes with you, and he will not leave or forsake you. Deuteronomy 31, 6.
Eden, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, the Lieutenant Governor of Ontario Community Volunteer Award, Citizenship Gold Bar Second Level, WAVES Honor Certificate, Athletics Gold Bar Third Level. Eden is an independent, confident, and focused worker who is willing to be her own person, offering what she thinks and feels simply and clearly. She is courageous, trying things others won't. Eden is a quiet leader, a consistent helper, a disciplined athlete who exhibits a tremendous depth of character. So for Eden, but thanks be to God. He gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my dear brothers and sisters, stand firm. Let nothing move you. Always give yourselves fully to the work of the Lord, because you know that your labor in the Lord is not in vain. 1 Corinthians 15, verse 57 to 58. David, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Ontario Scholar Certificate, WAVES Honor Certificate, Citizenship Gold Bar Second Level.
David has a strong thirst to learn and to grow. He's a deep and abstract thinker who likes the challenge of a logical problem. He's reliable, dependable, and servant-hearted, and always willing to help, serving graciously and quietly behind the scenes. He does not take things at face value and always seeks to understand the why, not just the what. So to David, his master replied, "Well done, good and faithful servant. You have been faithful with a few things. I will put you in charge of many things. Come and share your master's happiness." Matthew 25, 21.
Tiffany, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Ontario Scholar Certificate, WAVES Honor Certificate, Citizenship Medallion. Tiffany is a tenacious worker, a good friend, and a strong advocate. Tiffany has pushed herself to step outside her comfort zone, to try new things, and to rise to challenges. Tiffany is determined and persistent, seeking ways to grow and become her best self. So for Tiffany, the God of all grace, who called you to his eternal glory in Christ, will himself make you strong, firm, and steadfast. 1 Peter 5, verse 10. Jacqueline, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Ontario Scholar Certificate, Waves Honor Certificate, and Citizenship Medallion.
Kind-hearted and soft-spoken, Jacqueline is a gentle spirit who helps those around her feel at peace. Several staff members highlighted her great sense of humor. Jacqueline is amiable, thoughtful, and humble, and she is not afraid to think and to express her own thoughts. To Jacqueline, may the Lord of peace himself give you peace at all times. And in every way, the Lord be with you. 2 Thessalonians 3:16.
Abby, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Ontario Scholar Certificate, Waves Honor Certificate, Citizenship Gold Bar, Second Level, Athletics Gold Bar, Second Level, MVP of Girls Volleyball, and the Female Sportsmanship Award. Nope, not yet. Abby is a capable and conscientious leader. She is an encourager and a team player. Abby leads not by words, but by example. She has grown tremendously in character and in confidence, inspiring others on the court and in the classroom. Abby is someone who knows what she likes and what she doesn't like and isn't afraid to share it. She is a great friend and a thoughtful contributor to the life of our school. So for Abby, I run in the path of your commands, for you have set my heart free. I have not departed from your laws, for you yourself have taught me. Your word is a lamp to my feet and a light to my path. Psalm 119, 32, 102, and 105. Kobe, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Citizenship Medallion.
Kobe has strong opinions, but he expresses them respectfully. His everyday demeanor, in fact, is gentle and very gracious. On the soccer field, he is transformed, playing with agility and a relentless, indefatigable drive that led one staff member to wonder if Kobe had iron lungs. Quiet and humble, Kobe sets and stays true to his own pace. To Kobe, let your gentleness be evident to all. The Lord is near, and the peace of God, which transcends all understanding, will guard your heart and your mind in Christ Jesus. Philippians 4, verse 5 and 7.
Kate, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Citizenship Bar, Gold Bar, Second Level. Kate draws in and draws the best out of others. She has been described as the social glue in our school community. She is caring, authentic, and modest. Kate creates gorgeous visual art and has a tremendous sense of personal style. So for Kate, may the God who gives endurance and encouragement give you a spirit of unity as you follow Jesus Christ, so that you may glorify the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ. Romans 15, 5 to 6. Mm-hmm. Gianna, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Ontario Scholar Certificate, Waves Honor Certificate, Citizenship Gold Bar Third Level, Athletic Medallion, and Gianna was our president 2022 of our Student Council.
Gianna is a well-respected leader because she always looks out for others. She bridges cultures and communities and extends kindness to all. She is positive, willing to take chances, and always cheering on her peers and her teammates. She may seem small in stature, but she is a giant when it comes to character, spirit, and leadership. Mm-hmm. To Gianna. And may the Master pour on the love so it fills your life and splashes over on everyone around you, just as it does from us to you. 1 Thessalonians 3:12.
Thomas, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Citizenship Medallion. Thomas is the school's greatest cheerleader on Edsby. He seeks to see the good in others and in the world. He always likes to know what is happening. Thomas always has a song on his heart that often escapes his lips. He moves to his own rhythm, which is appropriate given that he is consistently upbeat. So for Thomas, the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face towards you and give you peace. Numbers 6, 24 to 25. Hopefully Jack is watching online somewhere in Toronto. For Jack, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Citizenship Medallion.
Jack is courteous, industrious, and generous. He's an independent and forward-thinking with guarding his future and his plans, and yet he also takes the time to check in on you and ask questions about your life. Jack makes others feel welcome, always with an acknowledgement or a warm greeting. So to Jack, may the Lord give you the desire of your heart and make all your plans succeed. May we shout for joy over your victory and lift up your banners in the name of our God. And may the Lord grant all your requests. Psalm 20, verses 4 and 5.
Same, hoping Mike's watching. Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Ontario Scholar Certificate, Waves Honor Certificate, Citizenship Medallion, Excellence in Education Award for Physical Sciences. Mike is congenial, honest, and quietly brilliant. He is a logical person who enjoys and is good with complex concepts. Mike takes personal responsibility seriously and is not afraid to hold himself and others accountable for their actions. He is a deep thinker and a great friend. For Mike, grace and peace be yours in abundance through the knowledge of God and of Jesus our Lord. His divine power has given us everything we need for godliness and life. 2 Peter 1, 2, verse 3. Osaza, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Ontario Scholar Certificate, Waves Honor Certificate, Citizenship Medallion, Dean's Medal as the Salutatorian, the Governor General's Academic Medal, Excellence in Education, Science, Life Sciences.
Saza is easygoing and hardworking. Her heart is soft toward the Lord and compassionate for others. She is a very strong advocate. Saza is true to herself, deeply dedicated to her studies, and as one teacher stated, she is patient when she is educating me. She has a contagious smile. To Saza, and God is able to bless you abundantly, so that in all things, at all times, having all that you need, you will abound in every good work. 2 Corinthians 9 and 8.
Shay, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Citizenship Medallion. Shay is social and visits people regularly and often, even if it's just to say hello or share a smile or ask about your day. He loves to worship God, and he does it with a joyful heart. Shay looks toward becoming his best self as evidenced by his persistent and consistent, warm-hearted nature. For Shay, let love and faithfulness never leave you. Bind them around your neck. Write them on the tablet of your heart. Then you will win favor and a good name in the sight of God and man. Proverbs 3, verse 4. Jeremiah, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma.
Jeremiah is a gentle giant who's big in body, in heart, and in spirit. He's always willing to assist, and he does so without complaint. The strong, silent type, Jeremiah's words may be few, but his actions reveal a person of character and of conviction. So to Jeremiah, be strong, show yourself a man, and observe what the Lord your God requires. Walk in his ways, keep his decrees, so that you may prosper in all that you do and wherever you go. 1 Kings 2, verses 2 to 4.
Demi Lade, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Citizenship Gold Bar Second Level, Athletics Medallion, Male Sportsmanship Award Runner-Up, and our Male Citizen of the Year. For Demi, he is relaxed and soft-spoken, yet he is passionate about knowing God, doing his will, and making him known to others. He is a funny and dynamic storyteller. Demi is respected by and respectful of others. He is a servant leader whose wholesome character and authentic lifestyle encourages all those who know him. For Demi, he did what was right in the eyes of the Lord. He sought God, who instructed him in the fear of God. As long as he sought the Lord, God gave him success. 2 Chronicles 26, 4 to 5. Tito, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Ontario Scholar Certificate, WAVES Honor Certificate, Citizenship Medallion, the Rick McBay Chorus Award, the Athletics Medallion.
Tito embraces worship and uses her musical gifts to glorify God and to encourage others, particularly in faith. She is committed to self-growth, as demonstrated by her hard work and significant contributions to athletics this year. Fiercely independent, Tito is also caring, setting high standards for herself and expecting them from others. To Tito, worship the Lord with gladness. Come before him with joyful songs. For the Lord is good and his love endures forever. His faithfulness continues through all generations. Psalm 100, verses 2 and verse 5.
Olu Fusala, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Ontario Scholar Certificate, Waves Honor Certificate, Citizenship Medallion, Excellence in Education, Language Arts. Simi seeds a world that needs to be better, and rather than hoping for it to happen, she uses her voice and convictions to change the world. She is an advocate and an ally to those who need both. Simi is not afraid to ask hard questions, work through tough truths, express herself creatively, or share her great sense of humor. For Simi, commit your way to the Lord, trust in him, and he will do this. He will make your righteousness shine like the dawn, the justice of your cause like the noonday sun. Psalm 37, 5 to 6.
Okay, here we go. You ready?
Oluwa Shemilore, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Ontario Scholar Certificate, Waves Honor Certificate.
Oluwa Shemilore desires to do what is right, whether it is easy or not. Inclusive and welcoming, she wants what is best for others. She is always on top of what is going on, involved and engaged in school life, speaks her mind in thoughtful ways, and asks good questions. She is funny and a good friend. To Oluwa Shemilore, who is going to harm you if you are eager to do good? But even if you should suffer for what is right, you are blessed. 1 Peter 3, 13 to 14.
Olise, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Ontario Scholar Certificate, Waves Honor Certificate, Athletics Medallion, Badminton MVP Award, Male Athlete of the Year Runner-Up. For Olise, Olise looks ahead to the future and seeks to make things better and more fair for all. A skillful and accomplished athlete, he is passionate about sports and getting others involved in them. In classes, Olise is insightful, formulates his own well-considered opinions, and expresses them articulately. For Olise, lazy hands make for poverty, but diligent hands bring wealth. Blessings crown the head of the righteous. Proverbs 4, 4 and 6. Sharon, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Ontario Scholar Certificate, Waves Honor Certificate, Grade 12 Bible Scholarship Award, Dean's Medal as Salutatorian, Excellence in Education Award for Humanities.
Sharon is well-spoken, confident, and gracious. She finds the best in others and in our school, and she loves to highlight it. Sharon is hardworking, fun-loving. She's easy to approach. She has a warm personality and displays tremendous energy, courage, and determination. So to Sharon, blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Matthew 5, 6, and 8.
Malachi, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Male Sportsmanship Award, Boys Basketball MVP. Malachi is a great listener with a quick smile and a welcoming spirit, a stellar basketball player who one staff member simply describes as he dunks. He does not let his success go to his head, though. Rather, he is humble, respectful of and generous to his teammates. Malachi has a joy for life that brings out the best in those around him. For Malachi, God opposes the proud but shows favor. Oh, okay. All right. Okay, we'll start that one again. God opposes the proud but shows favor to the humble. Submit yourselves then to God. Resist the devil and he will flee from you. Come near to God, and he will come near to you. James 4, 6 to 8. Monica, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Citizenship Gold Bar Level 3 and 4 this year.
Yannicka is a diligent and reliable worker who identifies what needs to be done and then she does it well. Friendly to all, trusted by those who know her, she serves wholeheartedly with a dedicated conviction to improve the life of our school community. Yannicka thinks deeply about her faith and her relationship with Christ. To Yannicka, whatever you do, work at it with all of your heart as working for the Lord, not for human masters, since you know that you will receive an inheritance from the Lord as a reward. It is the Lord Christ you are serving. Colossians 3, 23 and 24.
Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Ontario Scholar Certificate, WAVES Honor Certificate, Citizenship Medallion, the Euclid Math Contest Medallion, Excellent in Education Award in Mathematics. Irene is perceptive and observant, and there is very little that gets by her. She exhibits a joyful kindness and is always willing to help where help is most needed. Irene is intelligent and wise, and more than one person remarked that she is simply quite brilliant and could give Einstein a run for his money. So for Irene, to the person who pleases him, God gives wisdom, knowledge, and happiness. Ecclesiastes 2, verse 26. Theodore, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Waves Honor Certificate, Citizenship Medallion, the Rick McVeigh Chorus Award, the Milford Boyle Memorial Bible Award Runner-Up, Excellence in Education Award in Technology and the Trades.
Teddy is inquisitive and curious, always trying to learn and to grow creatively, intellectually, and spiritually. A talented musician and singer, he loves to worship through music. Teddy gets involved in a multitude of things and is always quick to offer a hand. He lives his life with an eternal perspective. So to Teddy, do not let the book of the law depart from your mouth. Meditate on it day and night so that you may be careful to do everything written in it. Then you will be prosperous and successful. Joshua 1:8.
Etienne, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma. Etienne is not easily riled, maintaining a cool, calm, collected demeanor. While he does not speak loudly or often, he is not shy to ask challenging questions. He is affable and an agreeable person with a cheerful smile. Etienne is a valued collaborator who works and plays well with others. For Etienne, grace, mercy, and peace from God the Father and from Jesus Christ, the Father's Son, will be with you in truth and love. 2 John 3. Tiffany, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Citizenship Medallion.
Tiffany's Great Lakes journey exemplifies the positive transformation that can happen over time when one is willing to take chances, to step up, to try new things. Once a quiet, unassuming student, she is so cheery, social, and boundlessly positive. Tiffany gives her all, whether she's playing a sport, tackling a class, or being a good friend. To Tiffany, the Lord is my light and salvation. Whom shall I fear? The Lord is the stronghold of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? Psalm 27:1.
Nancy, Ontario Secondary School Diploma, Great Lakes Christian High School Diploma, Ontario Scholar Certificate, Waves Honor Certificate, Citizenship Medallion. Nancy is a quiet worker behind the scenes. She applies herself diligently and conscientiously to whatever she is tasked to do. She is a stellar badminton player, strong academic, and focused student. Nancy will prosper because once she sets her sight on desired goals, she does whatever it takes to accomplish them. For Nancy, do not forget my teaching, but keep my commands in your heart, for they will prolong your life many years and bring you prosperity. Proverbs 3, verse 11.
Before we finish tonight, it is always good to look back a little bit and reflect. So several times This morning in our grad chapel, the OG was referenced. And for those of you not in the know, OG's actually been around for decades, but it was popularized in 1991 by rapper Ice-T when he released his best-selling album, Original Gangster. Well, since then, OG has come to mean in general, original, or an originator. And 7 of our 33 graduates are OG, or they've been here since grade 9. Let's take a peek. So there you go, that's our OG. You know, it's always amazing to me. You take a look and you go, who's changed and who hasn't changed? It's amazing. Okay. Well, whether you've been here for 4 years or whether you've only been here for one, I want you to know today that actually the town of Lincoln is celebrating with you. This morning, our GLCHS flag was flown at Town Hall, and they're going to keep it up over the weekend as a congratulations and to celebrate the class of 2022 from our school. So in addition, Mayor Sandra Easton sends her kind regards and congratulations and highlights how much the local community appreciates and values our students. Graduates, we have tried in the best ways we know how to equip you for the race that you must continue to run. In all that you do from this day forward, remember, you are never alone. God is with you always, but also look around to your families. Keep close to your friends. You will move on from here, but you will not be forgotten. We will always be here for you also. Stay connected. Please visit and call on us anytime. And never be afraid, though, to keep moving forward as servants, as leaders, and as godly people. Before we can conclude this graduation ceremony, we have some thank yous that we need to make. So first, thank you to you, the students. You have educated us, even as we have tried to educate you. May we all be stronger and better for that. And we thank you for encouraging us as we tried to serve you. Parents and guardians, you have entrusted us to help develop your precious children. And we thank you for that honor and for that privilege. Yes, even when it was difficult. To our families, to our supporters, to our volunteers, including but certainly not limited to the board of directors in our corporation. Without all of you, we could not do what we feel by God that we are called to do. I wish that all of you could have attended Grad Chapel this morning. Several students in this class shared memories, laughter, tears, thank yous, and encouragements. But in their words, they not only called out friends within the school community and the student body, but they called out many of our teachers and other staff members. And to me, that is the greatest testament to the impact that our staff and teachers have and the dedication that you have to serving these young people. I am humbled by and I am grateful for all of you. Thank you. Obviously, days like today, and I don't know if you've only been with us for part of it or just for tonight, but none of this just happens. There are a lot of people that have been involved. And I can't highlight absolutely every person, but I do want to say a few names. Caroline Krault and all the volunteers who worked on the beautiful flower arrangements. To the Waves, our women's auxiliary support group that prepared our luncheon. Our facility staff and all the other staff who helped them clean up, set up, and transformed our campus for these year-end events. To Suzanne Banta, who prepared all the things on the table and all the calculations to make sure that we were giving the honor cords to the right people. We want to thank our sound and tech crew, Josh and John, and our student volunteers behind the scenes, Zion, Ben, and the new student council executive. We want to thank Dwayne Williams as our grad marshal and walking everyone through this before it actually happened. If I've missed you, please forgive me. There's just so many. And that, too, is an incredible indication of the servant hearts that exist in our community. I want to highlight Dr. Martin Kahn, our resident historian and photographer, who continues to roll with us as we change things. To all the participants in our program this evening, thank you. And to conclude, the Apostle Paul says words that I would like to borrow and share from the staff and the faculty to you graduates. And we pray that you, being rooted and established in love, may have power, together with all the saints, to grasp how wide and long and high and deep is the love of Christ, and to know this love that surpasses knowledge, that you may be filled to the measure of all the fullness of God. Ephesians 3:17-19. Would you all please stand? Please remain standing. We're first going to be led in a prayer by Teddy, and then we remain standing as we sing together our school song led by Simi and Tito.
Please pray with me. Lord, you are a good God. You uphold all things in by your hand. We stand here today, finished high school and moving on to the next chapter of our lives, and we pray that your blessing would follow us. Continue to be with us. Let us be your salt and your light in this world. And as we start this new chapter of our lives, that you would continue to go with us and that we would continue to grow in our faith with you. I want to thank you for this night, that all the people who could come out, and I pray that they would go out fulfilled, seeing their loved ones and others, their classmates, and knowing that they have run the good race of life, of high school, and are moving on. I thank you for this day and for the people who could be here. And I pray that you continue to bless us. And all God's people said, amen.
Please try your best to sing along. If you don't know it, that's okay. Yeah, okay.
In the heart of Niagara Peninsula is a school we all love so well. She develops our minds into knowledge. As Christian with Christian we dwell. GLCC, we love you. Our dear alma mater today. Fond memories of you we will cherish. You're in all our hearts to stay. Years will come, years will go, but we will always cherish friendships that were begun. As we worked, played, and worshiped together to prepare for the race we must run. GLCC, we love you, our dear alma mater today. Fond memories of you we will cherish. You're in all our hearts to stay.
Please remain standing for the recessional, and may you all go in God's grace and God's favor.